Hello everyone, this is Ryan with PC Part Picker, and we're back with another build video. Today we're putting together a machine for Barry, our technical specialist. It's a hybrid gaming and work machine. So he's got the i5-6600K processor from Intel, a GTX 970 for gaming, hardcore Minecraft, an H100i GTX CPU cooler, a 750-watt power supply, Z170 motherboard, 16 gigabytes of memory, a 240-gigabyte M.2 SSD, some custom cables, and all of that is going inside of the Fractal Define S case, which they have kindly provided us for this video. So let's get started. We'll start our build with the motherboard and the CPU, two of the most important parts of the computer. Remove the motherboard from the box, and let's see what's inside. Open the latch on the side of the socket on your motherboard. And take your CPU out of the plastic case. On the CPU, you'll notice that there's a little triangle on the corner. This indicates pin 1, and there's also a dot on the socket as well. Line these up, and the processor should fit right into place. Close the socket, and then latch it together. This plastic socket cover will pop off, and we can put it to the side. Now install your memory into the motherboard. This board notes right on the PCB if you're only using two DIMMs that you would use socket 2 and 4 first. For our purposes, we're using four DIMMs, so we'll open all of the sockets, the latches on either side, then line up the notch on the DIMM with the notch here, place the memory in, and push down on either side. You should hear a click. Now install the SSD into the motherboard. Barry has opted to use a single M.2 drive, so we don't have any 2.5-inch or 3.5-inch drives in this build. Unscrew the screw from the standoff. Place the SSD into the M.2 slot. And screw it in. Before you place your motherboard into the case, don't forget to install your I/O shield. You don't want to have to remove all your components to put this in at a later step. Place it in, and it should click in all four corners. Fractal has provided us with a tool to help make screwing the standoffs in a little bit easier. You can see this goes onto the head of the standoff, and then you can screw it in. Take your motherboard and gently lower it into the case. Line it up with the standoffs and the I/O shield at the rear. Now screw the motherboard into the standoffs. With the motherboard in place, connect the front panel cables from your case to the headers on the motherboard. We'll start with the HD audio. Then move on to our power switch, our reset switch, our hard drive LED, and our power LED. First one is our power switch. Next we have our hard drive LED. And our reset switch. And our power LED. Then plug in the USB 3.0 header on the motherboard. To install the H100i GTX we need to first put a backplate on the motherboard. I've already adjusted the posts to the inner slot, and this should fit right onto the back of our board. Then, we'll connect one screw on this side and flip it around to show you the rest. Barry has chosen to use his own fans for this build, so we're replacing the stock ones with the Corsair AF120 and AF140 fans. Take off the front of the case so we have access to the front fan mounts. And then we'll remove the dust filter, which is magnetic, and unscrew the fan. Mount the 120 millimeter fans to the front of the case. You may have noticed when we installed the first fan that the cable was quite a bit shorter than normal. For this build, Barry is using custom cut fan links so that they perfectly go into the holes at the back of the case. And from there, we'll use custom sleeve cables to fit into a fan controller. Replace the dust filter on the front panel to the case. The dust filter slots in and then just folds over. We'll click in from the magnets, and the front panel should clip right into place. When securing the fans to the radiator on your CLC, you want to put the washer onto the screw first to protect the fan from any damage. Take our fan, place it on top of the radiator. The top of the Define S has panels in place to keep the case a little bit quieter. For our build, we're using the H100i GTX, so we need to remove them to get some airflow. There's a couple posts on one side, and this should pull right off. These ones, you just push from here. Push. Push. Pop right off. Take the radiator and your CLC with the tubes pointed towards the back of the case and screw it in at the top. We're starting with a middle screw hole here so that the radiator is secured and we can get the rest of the screws in easily. When you purchase a CLC and use one in your build, you'll notice that there's a plastic protective covering on the bottom of the CPU block. This is to protect the pre-applied thermal paste on the block itself. We'll line this up with our socket and the screws and screw it in with the provided thumb screws. Now that we have the thumb screws started, we'll secure them in a star pattern to evenly distribute the paste. The H100i GTX comes with a pretty long fan cable, so we're going to show you a quick trick to shorten the cable and keep it usable. Take a screwdriver and just roll the cable around it tightly, and then we can plug directly in to our fan header. Normally, we would install our cables onto the power supply before we place it into the case. For Barry's build, though, we're using full sleeves with PET, and it's just a little bit easier to route them through the grommets first and connect them to the power supply second. The Fractal Define S has a fan grate at the bottom with a dust filter, so we'll be pointing the fan on our power supply down. Secure the power supply to the case with the provided screws. We're routing the 24 pin through the grommets and connecting it to the power supply. And now we'll run the 8-pin EPS connector. With Barry's custom sleeves, we're going to do a little routing with them using the provided cable management Velcro before plugging them in. And then route the cable through the top of the case. We'll do the same thing with the 24-pin cable. To manage all of his fans, Barry is going to be using the Corsair Commander Mini. We need to remove the SSD holders, and we're going to mount it to the back of the case. Our Commander Mini is going to go right here and line up with the corner. But first, we need to apply double stick to make it secure. Now we've already connected our front fans to the extensions, so we'll plug those into the fan controller now. Before we place our video card into our motherboard, we need to remove the expansion slot covers from the back of the case. Open the latch on the PCIe slot and lower the graphics card into place. Secure the graphics card to the back of the case with the screws we removed earlier. Finally, we'll plug in the PCIe cables and connect them to the graphics card. All right, now that we've got everything together, let's push the power button and make sure it's working. Like our fans are spinning up. And we've made it to the BIOS. And that's the screen we're looking for. Now all we have to do is install the operating system and we're good to go. All right, well thanks for joining us for another successful build video. I'm sure Barry's gonna enjoy playing Minecraft on this machine. A big thanks goes out to Fractal for providing us with this case. So if you like the content or you enjoyed anything, please give us a like and subscribe down below.